Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Ako po si G. Tonji and welcome to Kababayan Today. Dahil buwan ng pag-ibig, makakasama natin ang dalawang Phil-Am na ikakasal ngayong buwan na ito ng Pabyero. Nakakatuwa ang kanilang love story at nandito sila upang ikwento sa ating ang napakagandang romansa nila. Umpisahan natin with a bride-to-be, the very beautiful and glowing Mia McLeod is here, who is the business owner of a real estate firm in Walnut, California called McLeod & Associates, and also has regular segments here on Kababayan Today called The Real Estate Buzz. She will be joined by her fiancé, pero mamaya na yon, na si Leonard Mercado, soon to be Mrs. Mia Mercado. She's here on the show. Hi, Mia!
Hi, good to be here. Oh my gosh, that opening was very dramatic.
Oh, the it's a big deal. You're getting married. I remember 10 years ago when I was getting married, a lot is going through your head. You know, this is one of the biggest days of your life.
Yes.
So I was hoping that you could come on the show and share your experience because, you know, it's not easy putting together a wedding, lalo na when it's a destination wedding. Sa Pilipinas po gagawin ang kanyang kasal.
Yes.
So, let's start from the beginning. Ikwento mo naman sa amin, paano mo nakilala si Len?
Believe it or not, my mom is the one that introduced us. But him and his family used to buy tickets from my mom's travel agency that's been around for like 30 years.
Okay, so you know in the Filipino culture, pagkilala ng nanay, and you know, it seems like it's really a family affair.
Yeah, so, and you know, we didn't really notice each other that much, to be quite honest, even though he'd been buying tickets from my mom's travel agency. Not until he got into the real estate business and he actually opened up a real estate office not too far from mine.
Okay, and so you guys do the same thing.
Yes, he's a real estate broker as well.
All right, so how is that couples that work together?
Well, it could be challenging at times, but honestly, we've always had the best business chemistry from day one. So I can see how it could be challenging for maybe other couples that decide to work together. But I don't know, with God's grace, I just have to say it's one of the better decisions that I've ever made because, yeah, it makes work a lot more fun.
And, you know, si Len, bilib na bilib ako kay Len kasi magaling magtagalog si Len at tinuturuan ka niya,
yes,
di ba?
Yes, I'm so jealous. He speaks so well, but he was also born here.
Oh, di ba?
Yeah, and then I'm like, but they required him to speak Tagalog in the house.
Yon,
they were very, very strict. But nag-aaral na ako.
Nag-aaral ka. So, Mia, because you're also engaged and marrying another Filipino-American, what does that mean to your culture?
One, to be honest, I never thought I was going to marry a Filipino when I was younger, let alone a Tagalog-speaking Filipino, so it's kind of really funny. And then my last name is McLeod, even though I'm a, you know, I'm
Filipina,
true Filipino all the way, but I've always had that last name, so it's really like kind of coming full circle in a way, because now I'm taking on a Filipino last name, which is Mercado.
Mercado!
But luckily, my initials stay the same, right?
Oh, triple M na ngayon.
I know, so I'm like, maybe it's really meant to be. I don't have to change my initials.
Okay, so let's talk about the proposal, because it was, I mean, I saw the video.
Okay, yes.
And how did that come about? I mean, your office conspired.
Yes, it actually wasn't even at our office. It was at a good friend of ours in San Diego. And oh gosh, I'm a hard person to surprise. And they really surprised me. So I don't know how he did it. But for those who have never been surprised before, it was really a shock. And then I looked up and then there was like family members upstairs. They were not there, and all of a sudden they were there and we're all the way in San Diego. I mean, it was a great, I don't know how he pulled it off, because if I see even a family member, I'll know something is up.
Right.
Yeah, so he did good. And he definitely had that whole surprise element going for him, so darn.
I know you've been really very busy because, you know, your wedding's taking place in the Philippines and a lot of your friends and family are coming from America.
I know, crazy.
Which is a great opportunity for them to discover the Philippines at such an important event such as your wedding.
Yeah, no, we're so excited. You know, we literally are, yeah, we have 100 people from here flying to the Philippines, which is just a ridiculous amount. We never thought we would have that big of a number from here, because one, it's far away and it's expensive. And so, But we're so excited. A lot of first timers. So I really
a lot of people love you guys.
Well, we're very grateful. We're so excited. We're grateful. We can't wait. It's only a few weeks away from now. No.
How is it how are you feeling? I mean, I remember days leading up to my big day. Hindi na ako makatulog.
I know. Well, no, you're right. And I didn't like how you opened up the show here. It's really a big deal. I didn't realize how big of a deal it was. You always dream about it, but you don't realize really what goes on until you're in the moment. Even when I reflect over this whole last year, from all the events, from not only the proposal, but engagement party, to the bridal showers, to the bachelor, it's just leading up to this big day. And it's so important for everyone, and especially for the Filipino culture. It's really interesting to see how my mom and my grandma and my sisters are. It's really nice.
Right.
But you don't realize, you only dream about it as a young girl, but when you're in it, you realize, oh my gosh, this is actually...
Eto na!
I know! Eto
na! Alright, pagbalik natin dito sa Kababayan Today, kasama pa rin natin si Mia, and we're going to talk about all the fun events that are leading up to the biggest day of her life so far. Don't go away, we'll be right back here on Kababayan Today.